Hi, my name is Candice Smith. I'm a first and second AD. I second AD your more international series and features, and I first AD local passionate indie projects. So yeah, how I got into it, I actually studied at the National School of the Arts. I studied theatre, and I wanted to carry on into the entertainment space, thinking I would want to be an actress, and I went on and studied performance for film. And so while I was studying, I went to go work at a casting agency to cast direct people for commercials and small things like that. And then how I got into the film side is I got approached by a director for a big commercial, and he wanted young people my age, early 20s, very specific extras casting. So I went out and I did a street cast and cast all my friends and did this commercial and then coordinated them all on set and was doing what I didn't know in the industry, but was called extras coordinating and casting. And finished my studies, kind of realized that there's not really a lot of money to be made as an actress, constant working as an actress. I started then working on sets as a PA and then a runner, and just to kind of see what department I worked in. And then because I'm a very loud and bossy person, I kind of found my way into being like a third AD, where you basically, a third AD is the extension of the first AD, where, you know, you get instructions and you go set up extras and for them to do crossings and things like that. Kind of worked my way up into being a second AD, which the second assistant director is a paper second, runs your base camp. You're the person that does the call sheet for the day. You make sure the actors arrive on time, they get through makeup and wardrobe on time, and they're on set on time. And you just basically, hopefully you get a base camp PA to help you, but you are just the one that's like pushing the cast through the works to make sure they're on set on time for the first AD. And I became a second AD because I was on a TV series as a third, and the second got ill. And they were just like, oh, well, you're the third AD, I'm sure you can second as well. And it's a very different job. Had to swim in from the deep end and learn very quickly what it was. And then, saw that there was a very big gap in the market for good paper second ADs, and worked my way up into some of the bigger, prolific shows and movies we've done here. I always also wanted to first, because, you know, the first AD, you work really closely with the director. You are the mouthpiece on set. You are basically a beacon of information. So you communicate with all the crew and cast while your director can focus on the acting performance and, you know, watching playback and all that. And you are basically, in the beginning of the production, you have to schedule it, which is the hardest part. So you have to read the script and break it down on how you're going to shoot it. And it's difficult because you get complications of actors' unavailabilities, location issues, and, you know, weather. Things are always changing. So you got to keep ahead of that, and you got to, you know, keep on thinking ahead of what you're going to be shooting and how it's going to be possible. On set, you have to be able to work with a lot of different personalities and a lot of egos. Sometimes I have to tell, you know, a grown man that's 20 years my senior what to do. It can get very tricky and very difficult with egos and such. But yeah, you have to kind of just go with the flow and be able to adjust to different people and different personalities. You know, your main goal is just communication, to communicate to everybody what's going on, where we're going to next, and all that. It also helps if you have a loud voice and you're very bossy. Yeah, in short, what ADs are is we just boss people around. If you want to be a first AD, you have to be a very strong personality. You'll always get it from all sides. People, you know, it's always the first AD's fault if you're running over. It's the second AD's fault if the actors are late on set. It's, you know, it's a lot of pressure and a lot of responsibility to the producers and the production to make sure you get the movie in the can. I advise anybody who wants to start in the film industry to go straight in as being a PA and a runner. In that way, you're running and you're working around in a lot of different departments, and you can kind of see your niche and where you want to be. If you wanted to be somebody like a first AD, preferably what you should do is you should work as a PA on set, a PA meaning a production assistant in the AD department. Then working your way up to being a third AD. The transition is normally a third AD to a first AD. If you are a second AD, you don't normally come from a third to the second. I just was lucky enough to do the whole department. But a second AD is more paperwork and you run base camp. So being a second AD, you'd go more rather into, I would say, being a production PA, working in production, and then moving into second. You know, if I advise people, when I studied at film school, I studied performance. I didn't study to be an AD. I became an AD from being a PA and seeing that that's the kind of position that worked for me. So you don't necessarily need to study at film school. If you're unable to go to film school, the best thing I would say is go and find production houses, send out your CV, go meet people. Instead of studying, go and become an intern, and just work your way up like that, because not all positions in the film industry you can learn from film school. Also, what I did is I used to have a scooter and I used to drive around with my CV and drop my CV off at a whole lot of different production companies. And I lied. I lied on my CV. I said I'd done this, but I didn't. But I winged it, you know? Sometimes just get it on a wing and a prayer. I definitely don't think I can do what I do without loving it. The amount of hours you normally do, you know, a 12-hour day, a six-day week for like months on end with people that you with all the time. And you do love it, because the people you work around become your family. They become your best friends. And we couldn't work the hours we do and the work we do if we didn't love it. And that's the thing. When I first, I only first passion projects and small indie projects, because first ADing is a hell of a lot of work. And it's not worth it just for a paycheck. There has to be a project that you believe in as well.